things you'll do for me. Nobody can do the miracles you bring my way. Even my mind, though, and let tomorrow, nothing can break through you. Can't be able to see your wonder in my life. The things you'll do for me.
Happy Sunday to you all, my beloved brethren. I want to thank God for giving us the grace and the privilege to come before Him in this special Holy Communion service. I want to believe that wherever you are connected from today, you are well and safe, and the Lord is watching over you in this season of global crisis. And I know that for you and your family, God will continue to watch over you. I will not allow the wickedness of the wicked to prevail over you. As you are aware that today is our Holy Communion service, and the Bible refers to the Holy Communion as a divine instrument of God's blessings, ready from the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 16. The Bible says that the cup of blessing which we bless, is it not the communion of the blood of Jesus Christ? And the bread which we break, is it not the communion of the body of Christ? So every time we partake of the communion, we trust God to inject and to release His miracle power into our life, which will prepare the manifestation of signs and wonder in our life. So the communion is actually a miracle means. So believe that as we partake of the communion today, God will be manifesting His miracle power in the life of every one of you in the name of Jesus Christ. So connect with God, make sure you get the communion ready, and by the grace of God, at the end of the message, I will be blessing the communion, and I believe that as you partake of today's communion, God's miracle power will manifest and touch you in every area of your life in the name of Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, I want to thank you for another privilege given to us to gather before you. I want to thank you for the gift of life. I want to thank you for prevailing over our life, especially in this season of global crisis as the pandemic is going around the world. I want to thank you for watching over your people, for protecting us, and for keeping us safe under your divine canopy. Thank you because you have not allowed the wickedness of the wicked to prevail over. Thank you because you have not allowed any one of us to be a victim of this virus. To you be all the glory forever. Father, Lord, we've come again upon Mount Zion, wherever anyone is connecting into today's broadcast. The Bible says that for unto you shall the gathering of your people be. Therefore, everyone that is part and parcel of today's service, let the blessing of this communion service be made manifest in their life in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, I decree that whatever does not glorify you in the life of your people, as we partake of today's communion, let that force be destroyed in the name of Jesus Christ. For the Bible says in the book of Matthew chapter 15 and verse 13, every plant which my heavenly Father has not planted, they shall all be rooted out. Therefore, as we partake of today's communion, whatever you have not planted in the life of your people, Father, cancer, you didn't plant it. Therefore, I command that by the power in the blood of Jesus, let them be uprooted in the name of Jesus Christ. Let diabetes be uprooted in the name of Jesus Christ. Let fibroid be uprooted in the name of Jesus Christ. Let leukemia be uprooted in the name of Jesus Christ. Let weakness be uprooted in the name of Jesus Christ. Let mental stability be uprooted in the name of God. Anything that does not glorify you in the life of your people, I decree that the power of the communion as you are given to us as a covenant meal, let everyone experience the manifestation of your supernatural power today in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, heal the sick, set the captives free, deliver the oppressed, break the chain of the wicked from the life of people. Let there be manifestation of your prevailing grace in the life of everyone today. Bible says, as the Father has sent you, so you have sent us. Therefore, the same order of grace that manifested and prevailed in your life, let the same grace remain manifest in their life in the name of Jesus Christ. Let this service be a blessing to everyone. Let this service open the week for signs and wonder upon everyone in the name of Father. Send your word to us in this season. Let the word bring transformation. Let your word impact your grace. Let your word provoke the manifestation of your grace in the life of your people. I decree once again that this week your hand will come upon your people, and everyone under the sound of my voice, the Spirit of the Lord will come upon them as the word of God begin to come, that will transform them and transfigure them and translate them from every weakness in their body to supernatural strength in the name of Christ. At the end of today's service, we all shall have every cause to glorify your holy name. Thank you for the gift of life. Thank you for the gift of salvation. Accept our thanks and praise again this morning in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' precious name we have prayed. Amen. Hallelujah. In this service today, by the grace of God, we shall continue the series of teaching which we started since the beginning of this month, as the Lord gave us a word of prophecy that says that His grace will prevail for us. Therefore, today we shall be looking at a message titled Unfolding the Prevailing Power of the Grace of God in the Journey of Life, Part 3. Unfolding the Prevailing Power of the Grace of God in the Journey of Life, Part 3. Remember, in Part 1, we looked at the definition of the grace of God, which is the unmerited favor of God that comes upon the life of men that makes them to do things that are beyond their ability and capacity, making them to do great things beyond their intellect, beyond their qualification. When the grace of God comes upon the life of a man or a woman, you are able to do things that people cannot imagine about you at all, because the hand of God is what break down the grace of God. When the hand of God come upon the life of a man, you do things that are compared to the manifestation of the supernatural. And I pray in the name of God, by the release of God's grace upon our life beginning from this month, you command result that can only be likened to that of the supernatural in the name of Jesus Christ. And in part 2, we went for that to look at the examples of men and women in scripture who receive and enjoy the manifestation of the prevailing grace of God upon their life, and how God used that grace that He released upon them to make them a showpiece of their word and a blessing to people all around them. And I pray in the name of Jesus Christ, the grace of God is being renewed and being refreshed in our life beginning from this month. I pray that God is going to make your life to move to higher realms, where you shall be a blessing to your word and blessing to everyone that come in contact with you, in the name of Jesus Christ. Wherever you go, God will make you a light. God will make you an instrument of impact. God will make you an instrument of deliverance. God will make you an instrument of signs. I want to God make you to be a blessing, a light that will lighten up the darkness of other people, that because of you, many will have their desired testimonies, in the name of Jesus Christ. Today in this part 3, we shall be looking at the virtues and the benefit of the manifestation of the grace of God in the life of men and women. What does that mean? When the grace of God comes upon the life of a man and upon the life of a woman, what will you experience? What are the experiences that will begin to manifest in your life? The grace of God does not operate in a vacuum. Every time the grace of God comes upon the life of a man, every time God looks from heaven and consider a man or a woman to receive His supernatural grace from above, the life of that man must manifest certain virtue, certain experiences, must command certain result, that when people see, they will know that this is not ordinary. Therefore, in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray that the virtue and the benefit that God has ordained His grace to manifest in our life beginning from this is it, your portion will come to you in hundredfold, in the name of Jesus Christ. The first virtue and benefit that the grace of God brings upon the life of men and women that we shall be discussing today is divine intervention that culminate in a life of positive surprises. Divine intervention that culminates in positive surprises. Reading from scripture, you are going to discover that every time the grace of God comes upon the life of a man and a woman, the resultant effect will always be exploits and testimony and experiences that makes people to say, wow, that big surprises to the life of men and women. People will look at the person and say, what has changed? What is going on? What has happened to this person? Because every time God's grace come upon the life of a man, it will not leave you the same. But as a result of the transformation, as a result of the manifestation of that grace, results will be happening, breakthroughs will be happening, blessings will begin to flow in the life of that person that will make everybody that used to know them to look at them and say, come on, something strange has happened. I am surprised at what is going on in the life of this person, because the grace of God is mysterious. Most of the time, the manifestation of the grace of God is so mysterious that it is difficult, if not impossible, for people to explain the manifestation of the grace of God. That is why most of the time, when the grace of God comes upon the life of a man and a woman, you begin to hear some people are from the secular world who don't understand the workings of God. They say, well, the person is lucky. They call it luck. They feel that something had just happened by happenstance, something had just happened by chance to them that is turning their life around, that people can no longer understand what is happening to them. But for people in the kingdom, you hear people when the grace of God begins to manifest the life of a man and a woman, you hear people say, well, it can only be God. It can only be God, because it is clear that this thing that is happening, this result, this manifestation in the life of this person is not ordinary. So for those who know that God does this, who understand the power of grace, they will tell you, well, it can only be the hand of God. It can only be God doing what he's doing. Then for those who are from the secular world, who don't understand, who have no knowledge about the manifestation of God's grace, they'll say to you that, well, the person is lucky. But however, the grace of God is mysterious, which no natural man can explain how it happens. But the result will always culminate in surprise that people will see. And no matter how they try to deny the grace, the manifestation of the grace will make them know that, come on, this is beyond the ordinary. And whether they like it or not, they must admit that something has happened in the life of that person. Let me pray this prayer upon your life. I don't care where you are, and I don't care what is going on in your life right now. As the Lord liveth, every subject of mockery, whatever is making you feel as if you are nobody, no matter what is going on around your life right now, I decree that God's prevailing grace will come upon you that will make your life a surprise to your world in the name of Jesus Christ. Very soon, people around you will soon begin to ask themselves questions, begin to ask you questions, what has happened to you? They will be so surprised and be so amazed. They will wonder about the manifestation of the grace of God. So every time the grace of God comes upon the life of a man, there must be surprise. Now, let us look at scriptures and examine the life of men and women who have enjoyed this grace. Like I keep saying to us, the essence of using scriptural example is to let us know that the same God that never changes. The Bible says that Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever. Hebrews chapter 13 and verse number 8. And the book of Malachi chapter 3 and verse 6, the Bible says, I am the Lord, I change not. So if God has made his grace available to men and women in scripture that we can see and we saw the exploit that people are able to testify about, it is a confirmation to us that if God has done in the life of one, he's more than able to do in our own life. So he prepares and builds our faith ready to know that if God has said so before and did in the life of people, we are next. Because now that he's saying it to us, it means that God that has never failed, he will not fail us. What he said he will do, that he will surely do. So when you look at scriptures and see how God has done in the life of other people, it becomes easy for you to believe that it is your turn. Especially now that God is saying that he will do it in our own life, your faith can easily be unlocked to know that the same God that did in the life of David, that did in the life of Abraham, the same God is still on the throne today. And I know that in my own life, he will surely do it for me. And the first example of the surprise result that the grace of God provokes in the life of men and women is in the book of Romans chapter 9 from verse 10 down to verse 16. In that scripture, Apostle Paul was referring to the experience of Rebecca and Isaac concerning the life of Esau and Jacob. The Bible says that while the children were still in their mother's womb, the voice of the Lord came from above and said to Rebecca, the two nations in your womb, it says that the elder will serve the younger. Now, this is contrary, as at that time, to the tradition of the Jew. As the tradition was, it is the younger person that served the elder one. But in this case, God, by his grace, decided to change the model operandi. God decided to change the way things have been operated that people are used to them. And God said, by myself, I have decided that I will change the way you used to know things. The elder will serve the younger one. As a matter of fact, Jacob have I loved and Esau have I hated. That hatred doesn't mean that God was against Esau, but just that God was saying that he has preferred Jacob over Esau. And the Bible went for that to ask. He said, with this kind of experience, it is clear that the children, none of them have done any wicked, none of them have done any evil, that we now say that is why God is making his decision. Then how do we explain this then? Do we now say that there's unrighteousness with God? Verse 14. And the Bible said, God forbid. He said, this is just a mystery. In verse 15, Romans chapter 9, verse 15, the Bible says, he said unto Moses, I will have mercy on whom I will have mercy, and I will have compassion on whom I will have compassion. For it is not of him that willeth, nor of him that runneth. It's of God that showeth mercy. Verse 16. So this is not about what anybody has done. It's not about what anybody is doing. It's just about what God just wants to do out of his own divine discretion. He wants to just use his own discretion to do things that will bring surprise in the heart of men. Everybody look and say, wow, what a great surprise. The elder will serve the younger. That has never been heard before. What a great surprise. And all through their life, as they live on the journey of life, you will discover that that prevailing grace rule over the life of those two children. And that grace still made Jacob take the birthright that was supposed to be for the eldest son in the family, which was supposed to be Esau. And we saw how the father's blessing came upon the life of Jacob along the line. Jacob, have I loved? Esau, have I hated? Like I said, that hatred doesn't mean hatred as in somebody being against somebody, but just telling us that God had preferred by his grace, I said, to prefer the younger one over the elder one. That is the voice of grace. Pastor, why? I can't explain. Bible says, who are you to question God? He makes the heaven and earth. He decided to make some black, some white. He decided to make some tall and some average. He decided to make some slim and some plumpy. He decided to make people, whatever he wants to do, he does it. We have no authority to question what he does. That is the power of the grace of God. That is why I'm praying for every one of you this season. Because we live in a world where everybody is looking for fairness. There's no fairness in the world. As far as the earth remaineth, there will always be the place of the manifestation of grace in the life of men and women. But I pray that because God has vowed that this season his grace will prevail in our life, I decree that that grace that is next will be released upon humanity is coming upon you in the name of Jesus Christ. Anywhere God is about to make his choice on the altar of grace, I pray that your name will be what will ring in heaven in the name of Jesus Christ. Surprise, surprise. Surprise, surprise. Not by power, not by might, but by my spirit, says the Lord. It's not of him that willeth, nor of him that runneth. It's of God who do what he want to do by the manifestation of his prevailing grace. Therefore, in the name of Jesus Christ, what no man has able to do for you, what your energy has not been able to do for you, what your intellect, what your qualification has not been able to give to you, I pray that by the manifestation of the prevailing grace of God upon our life, beginning from this month, I decree that God's grace will manifest in your life in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, as the Lord liveth, your life will be a life of surprise, surprise, in the name of Jesus Christ. Number two example of this manifestation of the surprise, surprise power of the prevailing grace of God. How do you imagine? Now, you think about it in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 16, from verse 1, that when Samuel came to the house of Jesse to pick a king. Now, you now give me some minutes of imagination that of all the sons of Jesse, like we saw in our last message, all of them were paraded, but the Bible says that all of them were disregarded. But now you now ask yourself a question. When David finally came and suddenly Samuel bypassed all other sons of Jesse, who had graduated, people in the military, people had all the skill and all the stature and everything to become a king. But the Bible says that Samuel bypassed all of them according to God's instruction. And when the forgotten, the so-called nobody was coming, the voice of the Lord said, this is the person that will be anointed as the next king. Now, ask yourself a question. Get through the room of imagination for some time and think. The kind of surprise, imagine the kind of surprise that will be generated all around the household of Jesse. The brothers of David will be wondering. This is strange. Everybody will be wondering, what happened? How possible is this? That is the manifestation of the grace of God. It provokes results and experiences. It brings about testimonies and miracles that culminate in surprise, surprise in the life of an individual. Therefore, in the name of Jesus Christ, God is going to do certain things in your life this year that will make you a surprise to your world in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, we also look at the life of Saul. I want to use the same example we used before to show to you how their life became a surprise to their world. In the book of 1 Samuel chapter 10 from verse 1, the Bible says, as soon as the grace of God came upon the life of Saul, Samuel said to him, listen, something has come upon you from today. Therefore, you are no longer the same person. As you leave this place, certain things will begin to happen in your life that are going to be surprised. He said, don't be surprised. That is a manifestation of God's grace. Just do as occasion permits you. So that you yourself will not be wondering, why is this happening to me? Why is this happening to me? And as you proceed in that scripture, the Bible says when you get to verse 12, so he met certain group of prophets as he was going. And saw the Spirit of God came upon him, and Saul began to prophesy as well. People who knew him very well from his father's house everywhere, they began to wonder, is Saul also now among the prophets? This is surprise. When did Saul now start prophesying? Because the grace of God has come upon him. He's now doing great things that has become a surprise to everybody that is around him. Therefore, in the name of Jesus Christ, there are people today that saw people think that your life is written up. There are some people today that thought that your life will never bring about good testimony. But listen to this. The grace of God is coming upon you that will make you a surprise to your world, a surprise to your family, a surprise to people around you in the name of Jesus. God's grace is going to turn you around on every side. And by the manifestation of that grace, your life will be a surprise to your world in the name of Jesus Christ. Another example that we're going to be looking at today is the life of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, remember before he went out to have a encounter that activated the manifestation of God's grace upon his life, he was just known as a carpenter boy. But the Bible says, after he came back from that encounter, he went about doing good and healing them that were oppressed of them because God was with him. Acts chapter 10 and verse 38. The Bible now said, after he did so much signs and wonder all around, a day came that he felt that, okay, let me now go to my place of birth, the place where I grew up. Maybe to go and also manifest these signs and wonder so that they will know that the grace of God has landed upon his life. And in Mark chapter 6 from verse 1, the Bible says when Jesus Christ came to his place of birth and he began to preach in the synagogue, the Bible says people that were listening to him, people who knew him as a carpenter boy, all of them were amazed. All of them were surprised. Then they asked themselves a question. Where has this boy gotten this kind of wisdom and this kind of insight that he does these great and mighty things? The Bible says, any of them will look at, is this not the carpenter? Is he not the son of Mary? We know his sisters. We know his brother. Where has he gotten this powerful manifestation that is exploding? Where has he gotten this encounter that has turned him around this way, that is making him do these mighty things that he's doing today? All of them were surprised. Bible said that they were so surprised to a point that they became angry because they could not imagine what has happened to the life of this carpenter boy that they used to know. They know how he was born. They know where he was born. They know his mother. They know his father. What has happened to this boy? The simple answer is that grace has landed upon him. So his life has become a wonder unto his world. Therefore, in the name of Jesus Christ, beginning from this season of the prevailing grace of God coming upon our life, God will make your life a wonder to your world in the name of Jesus Christ. Another example which I'm going to be talking about as well today is the life of Sarah. That is another great surprise, another great wonder that the world had, that people saw and they wondered about how things could happen. It's called the grace of God that came upon her. Now, imagine how people will receive the news, both her neighbor, both her relatives, both their friends and everybody around there, that a woman who is 90 years of age had just given birth to a bouncy baby boy. And the husband is 100 years. It has never been heard in history before. But when the grace of God came upon the life of Sarah, the Bible says that the Spirit of the Lord descended upon her. And what a great miracle. The baby that did not come all these years, the baby finally landed in her womb. And to God be the glory, at that age 90, she could still conceive by the manifestation of God's grace and give birth to a bouncy baby boy. That is what the power of God's grace can unlock in the life of men. You can be sure that people will be so surprised that you mean it actually happened? You mean she actually gave birth? You mean the baby is actually healthy? Ma, this God is a great God. Surprise, surprise, a life of wonder, a life of surprise unto our world. That is exactly what God has ordained. That's why in Genesis chapter 21 and verse 6, even Sarah said that the Lord had made her to laugh. And everyone that will hear what has happened to her will also laugh with her. Because she knows that it will be difficult for people to believe it, but God has done it by his grace. Therefore, in the name of Jesus Christ, whether you are also believing God for the same miracle, trusting the Lord that God should visit you with the fruit of the womb, I pray that the grace of God that came upon the life of Sarah, that made her to conceive even at age 90, I pray that that same grace will manifest in your life and cause you to have not just a baby, even have twin, even have triplet, that will make you a surprise to your world in the name of Jesus Christ. Finally, the young man speaking to you today, by name Pastor Kennedy, is a surprise. A lot of people who knew me from home, knew me from my town, knew me from childhood, one of the things they find difficult to believe, which is still a surprise to everyone, is to hear that Kennedy is now a preacher, Kennedy is now a pastor. How can it be? Because at the beginning of my life, all through my journey of life, nobody ever thought that even if the whole world become pastors, I will ever be one. But mysteriously, I was especially trained for it. I was especially prepared for it. But when the grace of God located me today, the manifestation of the hand of God is provoking signs and wonder and delivering God's word that is impacting many people today, that testimonies are flowing in on every side. And to God be glory, people sit there and say, how did Kennedy become a pastor? What has become of Pastor Kennedy? How did he become a preacher? Because the grace of God will always provoke strange things that make people get surprised when the manifestation starts occurring. Therefore, I've come to announce to all of you, don't write yourself off. Don't finalize your situation. Because the grace of God is coming. No matter how bad, no matter how horrible, no matter how hopeless the situation may be right now, in any area of your life, expect that God is going to visit you with his grace that will bring surprise to you in the name of Jesus Christ. There shall be surprise visitation for you. Certain things that people have not thought about you, certain things that nobody can imagine about your situation right now, the grace of God will make it happen and God will make you a surprise and a wonder unto your world in the name of Jesus Christ. In your marriage, God will give you a surprise breakthrough. In your finances, God will give you a surprise breakthrough. In the life of your children, God will turn their life around and make them a surprise to their world. In your body, God will give you divine health. God will heal your body and uproot that sickness that will make it a surprise even to your doctor. Your doctors will look at you and say, wow, I can't imagine what has happened to you. God is going to make sure that every aspect of your life is grace will speak. His prevailing grace will manifest that will make you a wonder and a surprise to your world beginning from this season. I have come to announce to you that beginning from this season, the grace of God that makes men and women a surprise to their world, I pray that that grace begin to manifest in your life from today in the name of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is the master of God's grace, is the transmitter of God's grace, is the one that brought grace to humanity. Therefore, in the name of Jesus Christ, as we partake of the body and the blood of Jesus Christ, I decree that God's grace shall be injected into your life and God's grace shall be renewed in your life in the name of Jesus Christ. I pronounce the communion that we are partaking of today as a communion of grace, that everyone that will partake of today's communion, I pray that you shall draw in the grace of God that will make you a wonder to your world in the name of Jesus Christ. That communion will bring the kind of healing into your body that will make you a surprise to your doctors in the name of Jesus Christ. God's grace will be drawn into your life through that communion table that will make you a surprise unto your world on every side in the name of Jesus Christ. And I command that communion blessed and sanctified. I declare that the power of God be injected into it, that everyone that partake of that communion that is before you right now, I declare that God's miracle power will be injected to your body in the name of Jesus Christ. I declare that communion a miracle meal for everyone that partake of it. May it provoke fresh grace in every area you so desire in the name of Jesus Christ. Finally, I want to encourage everyone of you to be sure that Tuesday, you do not miss the service. We are going to be unlocking another powerful virtue, another powerful benefit that comes with grace as we go through the journey of life. So don't miss Tuesday's service. It shall be a powerful time. It shall be a powerful broadcast. And I know that every one of you will be so impacted and be so blessed with that teaching on Tuesday. So speak to your friends. Give them contact to our YouTube channel and let everyone connect. Tuesday at 7:30 p.m., the service will be on. I have come to announce to you that as the Lord liveth, God's grace will begin to speak in everything you do and everywhere you go beginning from today in the name of Jesus. of Jesus Christ. I pray that in this season of global pandemic, may the grace of the Lord keep you. May the grace of the Lord prevail for you. May the grace of the Lord prevail over your family. May the grace of the Lord prevail over your children. May the grace of the Lord prevail over your career. May the hand of the Lord keep you. May your joy be full. May the Lord bring healing and restoration to the eternal nations of the world. And concerning you, God will bring healing and restoration to every aspect of your life in the name of God. Be blessed again today and stay safe under the cover of the Almighty God. Also, I want to let you know that beginning from Wednesday to Friday, we shall be having 3 days fasting and prayer as we prepare ourselves for our breakthrough and deliverance prayer night that will be coming up on Friday. Get yourself ready. This is not the time to slow down your spiritual life. It's not the time to take spiritual holiday. Keep charging up. Keep charging up. Keep charging up. Keep charging up. Because as the Lord lives, your eye will see the end of this pandemic and your life will be started up on a higher frequency to fulfill the will of God for us in this year 2022. Our movement to higher level. And as the grace of God comes upon your life, no devil will be able to stop your access in the name of Jesus. Enjoy the remaining part of the Sunday and have a very blessed week. God bless you. Stay connected in the flow of God's prevailing grace. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. Amen. Surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives. And we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Therefore, we are blessed, we are lifted, and we are going higher. 2020, our year of higher levels, a year of higher level, God's grace has prevailed for us. God bless you, and God bless you.
The things you do for me, nobody can do. The miracles are written my way, even on my mind, oh, electromagnetic. Nothing can break to you. I wonder in my life. I've never seen this kind of guy before.
Wonder, wonder.
Hey,
wonder, wonder.
I've never seen this kind of guy before. Wonder, 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 wonder. Wonder.